I'm sure you can hear my loud kids downstairs. I've told them to be quiet about 500 times, but I came in here because I thought it'd be quieter. Have the lights still low. Down low. But anyways, so I wanted to talk about Scandaval. I want to make sure that this picks up the audio because it hasn't been picking up the audio. I've filmed this. This will be the third time. And like three neighbors are mowing their grass right now because, you know, what else would be appropriate to do as soon as I start filming? Anyways, I didn't fix my hair today. It's just I got out of the shower and brushed it. Shows like a little snippet, like a little piece of Raquel's interview, and they said they were going to like do more on that later, so I'd say as it progresses they'll show more. It shows like a probably like a few minutes of each of them, but like Raquel's is like the shortest. She she's not as naive as people think, and she wants people to think she's naive. But anyways, Tom Sandoval, I've always thought he was a narcissist and a jerk. So everybody was so surprised by this. I didn't think it was going to be Raquel, but I wasn't surprised at the cheating because he cheated on Kristen. He already has cheated on Ariana, and now we know he's cheated on her. That he's admitted to, not just with Raquel for like 7+ months, but also with Miami Girl, who Ariana knew about, and also with another female that we don't know. That I wish she would come out and tell like about that and like how long it lasted and stuff. I don't think we'll ever get that after all the backlash of this scandal, you know. I don't think we'll ever get that from a woman to do because, you know. But anyways, it starts out with that. And then the first one on the stage, I think Schwartz was actually the first one. Comes out with Katie and Lala, I believe. Then Sheena comes out, and then, you know, Andy talks to them all and says, like, I want to talk about the looks for a moment. Oh, and then, of course, Tom Sandoval comes out and Lisa Vanderpump. But I want to talk about the looks. I think Ariana looked Chef's kiss is so like overdone. Everyone's like, Chef's kiss amazing, but she really did look was so hot. She looked amazing. And then Katie, I think her makeup, her skin, her hair looked absolutely gorgeous. I hated her dress. It looked like something my grandma would wear to like a funeral. But Katie's style's a little bit different, so if that's what she likes and feels beautiful in, then you know, more power to her. I love Lala's dress, like the cut of it, and I think Lala's makeup looked so bomb. I loved the smoky like cat eye with like that eyeliner in, really, really cat feline, you know, accentuates her features, and I just thought she looked beautiful. But her, like, I didn't like the print on the dress. It was giving very, like a dress. It looked really similar to a dress that I wore to a homecoming whenever I was, like, probably 2009. So, I think my, like, junior year homecoming. I did like the cut of her dress, and I know that that's very, you know, in that style is coming back like the 90s. I didn't really like the pattern or the print on the dress, but I mean, just giving my personal opinions. But I think she looked beautiful and amazing. Sheena, I think, looked amazing. I like Sheena without the extensions. I like Sheena with like a lob, like a long bob, even shorter than mine, like to here, like how she has it now. So pretty, like with her highlights and just like. Her hair is kind of colored similar to mine, and I feel like she looks amazing right now, but I could have done without the extensions, but she still looked incredible. Good as gold, you know. But anyways. Then they just got into, like, the timeline of it and, you know, asked Tom Schwartz, like, when did you know? And he says the end of August, and of course, like, Sandoval's like, no, like, end of August, what are you talking about, bro, you know? Because in the previous interview, it flashes back, and Andy obviously went over the timeline with him, and he said that it didn't happen, or he didn't tell Schwartz about it until, I think he said, like, mid-January, I want to say, and that was, like, a complete lie. Kind of proud of Sandoval for like telling the truth and not trying to sugarcoat it and say like, oh yeah, like, and say whatever Sandoval wanted him to obviously say. And then we have Ariana. Just, I feel like up until this point she's been very very calm and collected, and I was glad that she was able to release some of her anger, because I can't imagine being with somebody, even like she was willing. I mean, I even disliked her for some of the seasons because I've never been a Tom Sandoval stan or whatever they say now. I've never been a big, you know, supporter of his. I've always thought he was a dick, and I actually disliked her some seasons because she so blindly like stood up for him. So I was like, man, if you have a girl that is that ride or die for you and then you fuck her over, like, I just can't. And I'm sorry, but James, like, calling him a worm with a mustache was, like, the best thing I've ever seen. It was so good. And James is a hot mess, narcissistic asshole, but he is reality TV gold. He's so good. He's so funny. He's like a young British Scott Disick, and I have to say, James Kennedy is very entertaining. But anyways, back to like Ariana. I was glad that she was able to like get some of her rage out and really be like, you know, F you. Like, I don't know how much of this is obviously for the cameras, how much is like played out. I know that, you know, I don't think a lot of people are saying this whole thing is publicity stunt. Like, obviously, I don't think that is the case, because I would want to go through, like what going through, but also like I could never live with somebody, and I know in California it's so expensive, but I would be like, I don't care, you can live in your car, you can live in like the dump, like you can live anywhere, but like you're not gonna stay here. Like I'll sell the house and I'll stay with friends. Like if my husband, because you know this was her life partner of like 9 or 10 years, so I definitely think that she loved him more than he loved her. But I also think that like Tom Sandoval is not capable of loving anybody. I think when you're like a true narcissist, like you really only love yourself and what can benefit yourself at the time and who is stroking your ego. So not to get too deep into it, but anyways, I was just happy that she was able to get some of her rage out. Then I felt so bad for Sheena, because Sheena, you can tell, like truly loved Raquel and like let, you know, her stay there. And they didn't dive too much into it, like hardly at all, of like Sheena's, you know, relationship and stuff in it. I think that's gonna come in like part two and three. But I just felt bad for Sheena, because I don't know, I have a soft spot in my heart for Sheena. None of these people on the cast are innocent. Like they've all cheated, they've all been, loyal to their partners. But when you're with somebody for the amount of time that Tom and Ariana were together, and then also like you have to factor in that was like one of her closest friends, you know, and that he also like paid and helped like one of his really close friends an engagement for her, just like I believe it was last season. So it just shows you like the betrayal, and like everybody wants to compare it to this person and this person cheating on the show, but it's like there's never been a betrayal as deep as this, I don't feel like, on reality TV. I think that's why it's really shook everyone up, because it's like, oh my god, like, you know, and like I said, I expected Tom to cheat, and I think he's a cheater, but I didn't, until this season, I didn't obviously think with Raquel, because I really didn't see Raquel as the type of person to do this, and I also didn't think Raquel was like the brightest to like, and maybe that helps her, that she's so like naive and dull, and like people don't see her as a threat. But I feel like Lala really did call it from the start, and I'm not saying that I'm like 100% on Lala's side about everything, but I think that Lala is really good reality TV, and none of these people are like, oh my gosh, and like I said, none of these people are innocent, and it's reality TV, and it's TV, so it's like, obviously, some things are manufactured, some things are, but this, obviously, really, a lot of this was like raw, and I think that's another reason why people like resonated with it so much, because it was so, like crazy, and like so expected that it would be with Raquel. But anyways, that was really the spiel of it. James and Sandoval almost, you know, fought, but I really am curious to see what's gonna happen in parts 2 and 3, and I'm gonna do like updates on those as well. That's just like my take on it. Really was going through a lot of stuff that we already know through social media, if you follow any of that, and just like timeline stuff. It did go into a bit about Katie and Tom Schwartz's, like the breakdown of their marriage, and you know, as it came to no surprise, I knew that it would happen. have a soft spot in my heart for Schwartz. I think he's an asshole to Katie, but Katie was so demeaning and she just, I hate, I'm a girl's girl. I'm really, truly, I'm a girl's girl, so I hate saying anything like negative about girls, but she does seem very like negative and just like a miserable like kind of person to be around. So maybe that's just how they edit her for reality TV. But she's beautiful and I think she is funny sometimes, and I think the mic just turned off. I don't know. I don't understand this mic. It's like, it has a mind of its own. It really, truly does. So, like, why are you doing this to me? Anyways, my nose is itching so bad every time. Every time that I do, like, my makeup, and anyways, I just really wanted to get this up there because it's something that I'm interested in. I think it's a, you know, a cool, different video. I don't know, not different because everybody talks about this, but like in ASMR form. So hopefully this turned out okay. I'm hoping that the audio is not too crazy. I'm trying to get a better mic or get something worked out. Driving me bananas. But anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. And I know this is really lo-fi. I'm in my son's room, trying to be in the quietest